Have you ever heard of the Arctic grayling? Well, it's a fish that's an important part of Michigan's history. They were wiped out here in 1936, and now researchers at Michigan State University are working to reintroduce them to the state's streams.
In the state of Michigan, you know, right now we have brook trout, brown trout, rainbow trout, we have other Pacific salmonids, a bunch of non-game fish as well, tons of other species. But the big fish that's lacking in the Lower Peninsula is Arctic grayling.
The Arctic grayling is one unique fish. With this huge, colorful sail-like dorsal fin, it was once only found in only two states in the lower 48, Montana and Michigan. Michigan even has a city named after them.
So it has social value, it has environmental value as part of the original complex of fish species. Has cultural values.
But over fishing, competition from non-native species, and habitat destruction all played a part in the exploration of this iconic fish that was an important part of its ecosystem.
I like to use an analogy like Jenga. So if you've ever played Jenga, you have all these multiple pieces that are part of it. And we can think of an ecosystem as the Jenga tower, and each species is part of that tower.
Once you remove a piece, it becomes less stable. So the more species we lose, the more unstable the ecosystem can become.
And grayling were an important part because they were part of the food chain, both in terms of eating some of the aquatic insects that occurred in river systems, and they were all part of what gets eaten by bigger fish.
Right now, the fish can be found in Montana, Alaska, Canada, and Siberia. There have been many attempts in the past to reintroduce them to Michigan, all unsuccessful. In 2016, Michigan started an Arctic Grayling Initiative.
We started an initiative with the Little River Band of Ottawa Indians to try to bring the science together with habitat evaluations and modern rearing technology and see if we can make another go at it and reintroduce Arctic grayling successfully into some streams where they once existed.
With failed attempts in the past, you might ask, why are they doing this again?
We've learned from past mistakes. We've learned so much from the techniques Montana has used that now we can actually bring this fish back.
For Nicole Watson, being a part of this initiative is a dream come true. Her research on how Arctic grayling imprint on certain locations, on how many of them get eaten by predators, and what other fish they can live with in harmony has been going on since 2018.
Answering the questions of predation and competition, the predation trials allows us to figure out how many eggs we need to stock on the streams. The imprinting lets us know when, and the competition lets us know what fish these Arctic grayling are able to survive and cohabitate with successfully in Michigan streams.
She says several problems came up in the past, among them Arctic grayling simply swimming away from the rivers where they were introduced and not coming back.
Rapid out migration, which I am looking into by figuring out when these fish actually imprint to water. So it's kind of like a way for them to know where they are and know where to get back to. Plus, I also look at predation and competition with other fish. So that was another complication that was in the past reintroduction efforts.
Now they are trying new methods.
Before, it was rear the fish in the hatchery and they would hatch out of the egg stage. You would reintroduce them at either a fingerling, which is a fish that's about the length of your finger, or a yearling age fish, so a fish within their first year of life, or after their first year of life.
Now they are starting with the fish at the egg stage in the streams. She's been bringing eggs back from Alaska and rearing them in her lab since 2018. The coronavirus caused them to have a gap year in 2020, but this year she was able to bring back 10,000 eggs.
I incubated 5,000 at my lab, and Odin State Fish Hatchery had 5,000 of their eggs to incubate in their system right now. It takes about 3 to 4 years for these fish to completely sexually mature. And you don't want to take all of your eggs from one age class of fish. So we don't want to harvest eggs and milk from, say, only the 2019 fish, because there's a chance you could cross siblings.
And you might be thinking, why not just take the eggs from Alaska and drop them in our streams? Well, it isn't that simple.
You don't know for sure if there's going to be any bacteria, any viruses, any diseases that we don't want to introduce to our state waters. We need to make sure that these fish are healthy first. So it takes 18 months to go through a complete health certification.
Right now, there are 4 nominated watersheds where these fish could be reintroduced: the Upper Manistee, the Boardman, the Maple, and the Jordan.
And so we've learned so much that we think now is the right time to do this. And going forward, we're hoping that it will be successful. And based on what I've seen in the lab so far, I definitely think that we have a really good chance.
Reporting for Fox 47 News, I'm Tiana Jenkins.